Long ago, the ruins around Eckertsburg were actually part of a grand fortress. In those days, a kind lord lived in the fortress, and he had a great iron bell set in a tower. A long rope hung from the bell, and it landed outside of the gate. Anyone that needed justice or felt they'd been slighted simply could walk up and ring the bell. The lord would come down and hear their plea. Not too far from the fortress lived a knight, one of the lord's attendants. This knight was always hunting in the fields, running through the forest on his grand steed. It was a beautiful charger, almost as tall as he was, of a gleaming coat and sure footing. Everyone oohed and awed when they saw him upon it, and he was proud of that horse, riding it at every festival, decorating it in the finest of ribbons. Well, as all things do, that charger grew old, and then soon was no longer able to carry the knight as it once did. The knight, seeing no need to keep an old horse that couldn't do its job, simply turned the horse out into the forests and fields. This poor beast had never known the wildlife before. The horse was afraid. It didn't know where food or shelter was. It was barked at by dogs and kicked at by mules and chased by the beasts of the forests and fields. It began to starve, and as the winter set in, frail, hungry, and afraid, it saw the rope hanging from the bell tower and decided to chew upon it, hoping to get some sort of sustenance of any kind from that rope. And of course, when the horse began to chew the rope, the bell rang loudly, and the lord came down to see who it was that was seeking justice. And he saw the horse, in its pathetic state, its ribs showing through its dull coat, its eyes hollow. He felt a pang of sorrow. He recognized this horse. He knew who it belonged to. The lord told his vassals to bring in the knight, and he would talk to him and ask him why he had done such a thing. And sure enough, the knight was brought before him, and the lord demanded answers for why this horse had been treated so cruelly. And the knight just shrugged. "It's a horse, sire. What else am I to do with a horse that can't do its job anymore?" This made the lord quite angry. "How dare you treat this creature like this? It served you kindly. It served you honorably. It gave you its youth, its life, and this is how you treat it in old age? You will take that horse in. You will care for that horse as if it were still young, and you will love that horse until its dying day." Afraid to go against the lord, the knight simply bowed and took the horse back with him. And so the horse was returned to its stable and given fine food and ribbons once more, and it stayed in peace and comfort for the rest of its life. A good reward for a good steed.